Here's 5.5 quick Lightroom hacks to supercharge your workflow. Working against a medium or a 50% gray interface is ideal for color correcting, but it's vastly different from how the final images will be viewed on major social platforms like Facebook and Instagram, which have a predominantly pure white background. Lightroom has a great feature called Lights Out. By pressing L twice on your keyboard, it solos your image. This defaults to black, which again is not ideal, so a good hack is to change the color by going Lightroom Preferences Interface Lights Out and changing the screen color to white. Now, when we press L twice, we have a quick way of previewing how the image will look against white of our Instagram feed. This will quickly tell you if the image needs to be brightened or darkened, or if your white balance is off. And it's especially useful with images like this one to make sure there's detail at the edges of the frame versus going to a pure white. Another way you can do this is to use the S key to toggle soft proofing. Right-clicking will allow you to choose your proof background color. I keep this at 100% white to use in a similar way for an even quicker check, but I really prefer Lights Out for that clean and uncluttered full white balance and brightness confidence check. This next tip is for a set of images where the exposure varies and is useful if you've bracketed your shots or if you're shooting in an auto mode or an aperture priority and some of the shots turned out slightly darker or lighter than the rest. In this case, if I were to just adjust one of these images and then synchronize it, it wouldn't work. The color adjustments would look good, but the exposure would still be kind of all over the place. So what I'll do instead is select all the images I want to match, make sure the key image is highlighted, then go to Settings, Match Total Exposures. This automatically matches the set of images to the main image, giving a nice and even baseline exposure. This gets it really close, and then you can always fine tune from here or add a preset. Or if you apply a custom preset upon import, like I've shown in a couple of my other videos, using this feature as well will really supercharge your entire workflow. It will have you done and relaxing with that glass of wine in no time. Sometimes when you have multiple adjustments you've made on an image in Lightroom, such as this image where I have an adjustment brush that is affecting the background to add this nice glowy look, if I want to make any tweaks to this adjustment I've made to maybe dial it down or even dial it up a little bit, I have to go back through and adjust each one of these sliders individually. But there is a way to globally reduce or bring up those adjustments, similar to Photoshop with using the opacity on a layer. It's a little bit hidden in Lightroom, but if you go over here to these little arrows, it reveals a drop-down slider where you can adjust these brush settings up or down to increase or decrease the effect. And an even quicker way of doing this is going over the image and clicking on the adjustment layer and alt-dragging left or right as an even faster way of just adjusting this really quick. In addition to the adjustment brush, this same trick also works on gradient filters and radio filters, making it super useful. Once you have your basic image adjustments, there might be certain colors or tonal areas that you want to adjust individually to dial it in and make it awesome. And this is where HSL sliders come in handy. In this particular image, the greens are looking a bit fluorescent and are distracting away from the subject, so I'd like to adjust them for a more filmic look. Rather than adjusting each individually though, we're going to use the HSL Color Picker. And starting with the saturation, I'm just going to drag on this background part of the image to shift the saturation down. And then it's automatically, if you can see on the right, going to adjust for that part of the image, and it's adjusting both those greens and yellows accordingly. I'm also gonna do this for the luminance, dragging up on the background and also these leaves, as well as the hue to bring that to a prettier green. Here is the before and after. This is also super useful for skin tones where I tend to bring the hue to the right by dragging up to even out red or orangey skin tones and the saturation down just a little bit and tend to bring that luminance up for a nice luminescent look. Sharpening can help the fine details of your image really pop, but applying a global sharpness across everything can be really unflattering in portraits, where it ends up accentuating fine lines, pores, and just generally making the skin look crispy. But a workaround to just sharpen the fine details while keeping the skin soft and pretty is using the masking tool. So let's just overdo the sharpening for a second so that we can really see what we're doing. If you slide the masking up, you can see it's helping the skin, but it's hard to see exactly what it's doing and how far to take it up or down. So the secret is to hold down the Option key while dragging the masking, so you can really fine-tune what gets sharpened while keeping the skin soft. This last bonus tip is kind of half a tip, since it's a keyboard shortcut, but I thought it was worth mentioning because it's a great way of getting a quick confidence check on those deep shadow and highlight details. By pressing J on your keyboard, it'll toggle clipping mask to show where you're either under or overexposed. The red areas show where you're losing detail in the highlights, and blue shows where you're losing it in the shadows. And with just a quick adjustment, we can then bring back some of those subtle details. We can't control what kind of crazy monitors people out there are using, but at least this allows us to be confident that we did our job right. Hope these tips help supercharge your Lightroom workflow and help you get a little bit more time to binge watch your favorite Netflix shows. Speaking of, I gotta go. Oh, by the way, like it, sub it, ring it, and I'll see you next video.